Hello everyone. In this video, I'm going to talk about dietary management for peptides. Diet plays an important role in the prevention and treatment of peptic ulcer. Due to peptic ulcer, some parts in the gastrointestinal tract is affected, so the diet should provide adequate nutrition to afford rest to the affected part and to maintain continuous neutralization of the gastric acid as well as to inhibit the production of acid and also to reduce mechanical, chemical and thermal irritation. To achieve all these objectives, bland diet is recommended because bland diet is mechanically, chemically and thermally non-irritating. Now, energy. Most patients suffering from peptic ulcers are undernourished. So, therefore extra energy is recommended. Those who are confined to bed, the energy needs for activity are not necessary. Next one is carbohydrate. Carbohydrates are included to meet the energy needs. But at the same time, foods containing harsh or irritating fiber should be avoided. Protein. A high protein diet is recommended to provide essential amino acids for tissue protein synthesis, tissue repair, as well as for the purpose of wound healing. Proteins are also included because of their good buffering action. However, meat proteins ought to be avoided because meat extracts or meat soups have a high stimulating effect. It will stimulate the secretion of hydrochloric acid in the stomach. Though milk protein has a good buffering action, the high calcium content present in the milk also stimulates excess acid production. So, milk also should be taken as a moderate quantity. Egg and other protein foods need to be included to provide essential amino acids. Next is fat. Since fat delays the emptying of stomach, an increased intake is beneficial. However, fat is only moderately increased since the patients suffering from peptic ulcers are generally middle-aged executives or older adults who are also prone to atherosclerosis or hyperlipidemia or hypercholesterolemia condition. So, peptic ulcer patients can take unsaturated fats or polyunsaturated fatty acids or essential fatty acids and some emulsified fats like butter, cream or better tolerated. Next one is vitamins. Vitamins are also essential for the peptic ulcer patients, but especially vitamin C is very important for the purpose of ulcer healing as well as for the better absorption of iron. Minerals. Calcium should be taken to include sources of iron and calcium in the diet because bland diet are found to low in iron and vitamin C due to the restriction in fruits and vegetables. So, supplementation can also be given for vitamin C as well as iron. Zinc is also needed for the repair of damaged tissue and has protective effect against stomach ulceration. So, zinc supplementation can also be given. Fiber. A regular diet, including good food sources of dietary fiber, has proved to be beneficial. This is all about nutritional modification of peptic ulcer. Next, let's see about the studies. A large study which was conducted at Harvard School of Public Health found that high fiber diets were associated with the reduced risk of developing ulcers. So, foods are rich in soluble fibers like oats, legumes, barley, certain fruits and vegetables were especially protective, resulting in a 60% lower risk in this group. Diet high in vitamin A. In the another study which was conducted in the same area, intake of vitamin A in the form of food or in the form of supplement was associated with lower risk. The risk was 54% lower among persons consuming the most vitamin A compared with the least. Next one is green tea. Several studies show that regular green tea consumption is associated with 40 to 50% lower risk of gastritis because the bioactive component, that is catechins, which is present in the green tea, act as antioxidants and also as antibacterial effect. So this will suppress the H. pylori bacteria. Avoiding alcohol. The relationship between alcohol and gastritis and ulcers is complex and may relate to the amounts consumed. Chronic alcohol abuse favors H. pylori infection and also slows the rate of healing in existing ulcers. However, alcohol may also have antibiotic effects on H. pylori. Studies have found moderate consumption was associated with the lower risk of infection. However, in combination with smoking and alcohol, in any amount increases the risk of ulcers. Next one is coffee. Coffee in either its caffeinated or decaffeinated forms stimulates acid production. And in some studies, have suggested a close association between coffee intake and symptoms. Next one is probiotics. Probiotics may also interfere with H. pylori growth. So some studies have shown that probiotics also increase the effectiveness of antibiotic treatment for H. pylori and also reduce the side effects of treatment. Eating habits. Meals must be small and frequent. All foods and drinks which are either too hot or too cold should be avoided. The patient should drink 8 to 10 glasses of water every day. Milk should be taken in moderate quantities because the calcium in milk which stimulates the acid secretion. The fruits such as banana, apple, mango, melon reduce the acidity in the stomach so it can be taken. Some raw fruits and vegetables should be avoided as many of these are especially irritating. Those in an advanced state of disease should avoid whole grains, nuts and whole grain bread since it contains insoluble or harsh fiber. Greasy foods, fleshy foods, tea, coffee, tobacco, alcohol, spices and condiments and preserves should be completely eliminated in ulcers. Several studies have shown that vitamin A and E, especially taken together, have not only protective effect against development of ulcers caused by stress, but also a curative effect on existing ulcers. Avoiding food allergens may be helpful for people with peptic ulcers. Finally, I conclude, certain lifestyle choices and habits can reduce risk of developing peptic ulcers. Maintaining a healthy lifestyle through a balanced diet rich in fruits, vegetables, grow whole grains, quitting smoking and other tobacco use will also help to prevent developing a peptic ulcer. Untreated ulcers can become worse over time and lead serious health problems. Mostly peptic ulcers are healed by the proper treatment and nutritional therapy. So to avoid this disease, let's avoid hurry, worry and spicy curry.